Now the anterior triangle of the neck. Anterior triangles of the neck occupy the side of the neck in front of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. This is sternocleidomastoid muscle, and in front of it there are anterior triangle of the neck. Now the boundaries of the anterior triangle, in the midline or the anteriorly, it is formed by the anterior median line, which extends from the symphysis manti to the suprasternal notch. Behind, it is formed by the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Base of the triangle is formed by the base of the mandible, which is also called that lower border of the mandible. And also from the base of the mandible, which we extend a line to the mastoid process. So by this line from the mastoid process to the angle of the mandible, and this base of the mandible forms the base of the anterior triangle. Now the apex of the mandible, apex of the triangle is directed below, and it is formed by the suprasternal notch of the manubrium sternal. So there is the apex of the triangle, this is the base of the triangle, and this is the anterior border, this is the posterior border. This is the anterior triangles of the neck. Now these anterior triangles are divided into 3.5 triangles by superior valley of omohyoid. So this is the superior valley of omohyoid muscle, and another muscle is the anterior and the posterior valley of the digastric. So you can see over here, this is a just submandibular gland, superficial part of submandibular gland. I reflect it. You can see over here, this structure is the, you can see over here, the anterior and the posterior valley of the digastric muscle. So these muscle, anterior and posterior valley digastric muscle and a superior valley omohyoid muscle, divide this anterior triangle into 3.5 triangle. So triangle over here, this is the muscular triangle. The triangle above is the carotid triangle, and the triangle above this anterior and posterior valley of digastric is the digastric triangle, and then half triangle over here is the submental triangle. Now the another triangle, which is called muscular triangle. Muscular triangle is bounded by, in front, you can see there is the front, in front it is bounded by the anterior median line of the neck, extended from the hyoid bone, here is the hyoid bone, to the suprasternal notch. Okay, and behind and above, you can see over here, behind and above it is bounded by the superior valley of the omohyoid muscle. Behind and below, here you can see this muscle over here is the sternocleidomastoid, and floor is formed by the this muscle, this is sterno hyoid muscle, and you can also see one muscle over here is the sternothyroid muscle. Sternothyroid muscle. Contents of this muscular triangles, there is no significant content in this muscular triangle, only muscles are present, as the name is muscular triangle. And beneath the floor of thyroid gland, larynx and trachea, esophagus lies. Okay, so that is muscular triangle. Now the carotid triangle. Carotid triangle, the boundaries of carotid triangle. In front and above. In front and above, it is formed by the posterior valley of the digastric muscle. So this is a digastric muscle which forms the in front and above boundary of the carotid triangle. Behind you can see over here, the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid forms the boundary. And in front and below, in front and below, you can see this is the superior valley of the omohyoid muscle. So this is the boundary of the carotid triangle by the digastric muscle, posterior valley, superior valley of omohyoid, and anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Now there are important structure and contents of the carotid triangle. So as I reflect the sternocleidomastoid muscle, you can see this collapse structure. This is the internal jugular vein. As I reflect the internal jugular vein, you can see artery over here, the patent structure. It is the common carotid artery. which is dividing into internal and external carotid artery at the level of the disc between the C3 and C4, and also at the upper lamina of the thyroid cartilage. So here the common carotid artery divides into external carotid and internal carotid. The internal carotid is posterior lateral. You can see this is internal carotid and it is posterior lateral, and external carotid is anterior medial in the carotid triangle. They are named according to their distribution, as internal carotid supply inside the skull, brain and the structures, and external carotid supply the structure outside the skull. Now there are some branches of the external carotid artery, you can see, and content of the carotid triangle. You can see artery over here, this artery going downward. This artery is a superior thyroid artery. And then you can see, just as we go above, you can see one artery coming from external carotid artery. This artery is the lingual artery. You can identify this artery by a nerve superficial to that. You can see this nerve. This is the hypoglossal nerve, which runs superficial to the lingual artery. So this is a lingual artery, and this nerve is the hypoglossal nerve. You can see another structure over here, which is running behind this in common carotid artery and this jugular vein. This is the vagus nerve. This longitudinal structure is the vagus nerve. We will see other contents in the another specimen. Now the another contents of the carotid triangle. So again, I'm repeating, this is internal jugular vein. Behind is the vagus nerve. Then this is a common carotid artery divided into external and internal carotid arteries. The branch over here is a superior thyroid artery, which runs along the external laryngeal nerve. Another artery you can see over here, which is superficially looped by the hypoglossal nerve. This artery is the lingual artery. Now you can also appreciate, this is posterior valley of digastric muscle and this is anterior valley of digastric muscle. So this is the digastric triangle, so formed by the anterior and posterior valley of digastric muscle and by the base of the mandible and the line from the angle of mandible to the mastoid process. Now you can see over here, the hypoglossal nerve is the content of carotid triangle and also the content of the digastric triangle. So hypoglossal nerve is the content of both the triangles. You can also see sternocleidomastoid muscle. And you can also see the lymph node over here. You can see another branch over here of the external carotid artery, which is a posterior branch. This posterior branch is occipital artery. You can see clearly this branch of the external carotid artery is the occipital artery. One branch should be here, the medial branch of the external carotid artery. That will be the, you can see over here, the branch over here will be the ascending pharyngeal artery. The one branch over here is the ascending pharyngeal artery, the medial branch of the external carotid artery. So here we can see three branches: superior thyroid artery, lingual artery, ascending pharyngeal artery, and this is the occipital artery. Behind the neck of the mandible, this external carotid artery divide into maxillary artery and the superficial temporal artery. We can't see over here, because we have to dissect it. Now the suboccipital triangle and the pair of muscular triangle situated on east side of the midline. So here is the midline. On the east side of the midline, we have this suboccipital triangle in the suboccipital region. So here is the occipital bone, and below this is the suboccipital region, and a triangle over here is a suboccipital triangle. Now starting with the boundaries of this triangle, so this is the medial, lateral, inferior and superior. So you can see over here, superior medially, the boundary of this suboccipital triangle is formed by the rectus capitis posterior major muscle. So over here, this muscle is rectus capitis
posterior major muscle, and the muscle over here is rectus capitis posterior minor muscle. Superiorlaterally, the boundary of suboccipital triangle is formed by this muscle. This is obliquus capitis superior muscle. Inferiorly, the boundary of suboccipital triangle is formed by the obliquus capitis inferior muscle. These are the three boundaries of suboccipital triangle. As you see the roof of this triangle, a roof is formed by the medially by semispinalis capitis muscle and laterally by the longissimus capitis muscle. So here longissimus and semispinalis capitis has been cut, so you cannot see them. You cannot see the roof of the triangle. The greater occipital nerve. Greater occipital nerve is this nerve over here. Greater occipital nerve crosses the inferior medial part of the triangle. You can see over here the inferior medial part of triangle. Inferior medial part of roof of this triangle is crosses by the greater occipital nerve. At this greater occipital nerve, after winding the inferior border of this muscle, which is obliquus capitis inferior muscle, then it runs on the in the roof. Then it runs along the roof of the upward and medially along the roof of the suboccipital triangle. Another structure you can see superiorlaterally. Here you can see this structure, and you can also appreciate this structure over here. This is the occipital artery, which crosses the superiorlateral part of the triangle, superiorlateral part of the roof of the triangle, and it passes upward and medially. You can see it passes upward and medially, resting on this muscle. This muscle is obliquus capitis superior muscle. So there are two content in the roof of the suboccipital triangle, are our greater occipital nerve, superior medially, and superior laterally we have occipital artery. Now as you see the floor of the triangle, so here we will the floor of the triangle. You can see one bone over here. This is the posterior arch of the atlas bone. As you have already studied, between the upper margin of the posterior arch of the atlas and the occipital bone, there is a membrane extend. The membrane is posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. So posterior arch of the atlas and the posterior atlanto-occipital membrane forms the floor of this suboccipital triangle. So you can see now the content of this triangle. You can appreciate the blesel over here. This is the third part of the vertebral artery. The vertebral artery over here is the content of the suboccipital triangle, and below this vertebral artery you can appreciate the nerve. This nerve is the first cervical nerve. The first cervical nerve, dorsal ramus, supply the muscles over here. You can see obliquus capitis superior, inferior, rectus capitis posterior, major and minor, all are supplied by this cervical first nerve. And also there are other contents, suboccipital plexus of the veins. So that's all about the suboccipital triangle. You can see. Now again you can see over here, this is the specimen in the museum we have preserved. So you can see the boundary of the suboccipital triangle here. This is the lateral boundary, this is the medial boundary, and this is inferior. So superior laterally we have obliquus capitis superior. This is obliquus capitis superior muscle. The muscle over here is the obliquus capitis inferior muscle, which form the inferior boundary of the suboccipital triangle. And here there are the muscles which are rectus capitis posterior major and rectus capitis posterior minor. So these are the boundary of suboccipital triangle. And again you can see over here, again this is obliquus capitis superior muscle, this is obliquus capitis inferior, and we have rectus capitis posterior major and minor muscle. You can also appreciate this nerve is the greater occipital nerve. The nerve over here is the first cervical nerve, dorsal ramus, and we have the dead structure over here is the third part of the vertebral artery, which form the content of this suboccipital triangle. You can also appreciate this structure. This is red color structure which lie over the obliquus capitis superior muscle. This is the occipital artery. So that's all about the suboccipital triangle. Thank you so much.